today's program is on the topic column basis and grillage foundations. This column basis and grillage foundations are the foundations for a heavy steel structures, so which are being used in nowadays in the industry and as well as other structural steel, other civil structures. So they are, first of all, they are the column basis as the foundation, which is a concrete foundation which gives a proper support to the steel structure columns. So they are the, and how they are and what are they, and today's session we will discuss it. Let us see the what are the objectives of this column basis and grillage foundations. So the basic objectives of this grillage foundations is it provides the proper alignment of columns in plan. So according to the plan, so there are many columns and which will transmit the load of the superstructure to the foundation. So it gives a proper alignment and stability to the columns, first and foremost one. Second one is ensure the verticality of the columns. It also gives the verticality-ness of the each column, even in the serviceability time also. Each structure is having a fixed service life of even 50 years, even 100 years also. So it is very essential to the each and every column in a structure to give a proper and very vertical stability. So that also this column basis will be ensured. So third one is the limit of the deflection of the columns. So columns will bound to deflect because of the various factors and various nature of loadings and conditions at the subsoil conditions at the site. So this gives the complete protection to the deflections of that columns. And fourth one is the protect the base from the ground, from the floor, ground corrosion. So steel structures are, you all know it, susceptible to corrosions. So especially in ground, there are so many alkalinities and chemical actions were present in the almost all the soils. So those chemicals are bound to react to the steel metal and it is to be tend to corrosion. So it gives a proper protection from that point of view. So the fourth one is this one. And fifth one is provide the proper and firm anchorage to the column ends. So each column ends, actually steel structures are tie up with the nuts and bolts or connections and fasteners. And these fasteners are bound to be little bit shaky. So it gives, the column base gives a proper encouragement and holdness to the column ends. So these are the basic and main characters and objectives of the column base. And these, how many column bases are there? Let us see the next one. So column bases are the four types. So first of all, first one is the slab base, which is a simple slab base, which is a simple wider concrete block, which take care of the foundation requirements of the steel column. And second one is the gusset base. So gusset base is the another type of foundation which we will, I will explain in the coming slides. And third one is the pocket base. It is also a type of column basis which gives the foundation to the structure soil, foundation to that structure. And third one is the grillage foundations. Fourth one is the grillage foundation. Grillage foundations are the foundations which is a wider area of the, that loads, heavy loads will be coming to the some structures which are to be spread properly and safely. It has to be transferred to the ground. So grillage foundations will be useful in that point of view. So what are that each basis? Let us see. A slab base is a base which is usually reinforced concrete slab, as we will see in all the concrete structures when we will cast it. So similar way we will cast it, this slab base also. Steel column is connected to the flat steel base plate which is laid down on the horizontal surface of the RC slab. This is the important base plate which it is a element of transmitting the forces between the column and the foundation of the concrete block. So this is an important base plate which we have to be designed. This is the main important element. So the base plate is fixed to the slab by means of suitable fold fasteners or anchoring bolt. These, again, these bolts are very important which will be grouted into the slab base in a proper way by the facility of ferrules and other items, and it should be taken care of that load requirements either it to be tensioned or compression also. So in the both the cases, it should be it is also having a vital role of the stability of that structure. So anchoring bolts also very important while designing. And the second one is the gusset base. As I explained to you, second category is gusset base. What we will call it is also simple slab base, but in some cases the base plate in the slab base foundation becomes very thick as per the design requirements. In such a case, plate size can be reduced by using a combination of stiffeners. So suppose a plates are there and there should be a combination of other components like stiffeners and gusset plates, and the thickness of the base plate can be heavily, it can be reduced, which is economical and it is easy to design it also. So those type of foundations we will call it as a gusset base. So it is a combination of base plate and some stiffeners and other allied materials. Such bases are known as gusset bases. So third one is that pocket base. In some situations, the foundations have to be P foundations. There are different types of soil conditions we will come across while designing the any civil structures. So those foundations like piles and well foundations we might have been seen. Those foundations are deep enough to the subsoil strata, which will transmit the force through the frictional forces. So those foundations we will call it as a deep foundations. So this is a pocket base, is a type of deep foundations which is a encased concrete slab onto the steel structure, and it should be taken to be deep enough to take care of that load transmission of the complete loads by means of pocket base. This type of foundations, the load is transmitted by vertical deep shaft instead of having a horizontal spec. Whereas in column bases and gusset bases, we will transmit the load by spreading the, by increasing the area. Here in pocket base, it is a different, not by spreading the area, by deepening the foundation, we will transmit the complete load by frictional forces of this that shaft. So this is the difference between the pocket base and grillage foundations. And fourth one is the grillage foundations. So in this grillage foundations, if the, as I said to you, different soil conditions, there will be a very low soil condition. It has been common, low bearing capacity of the soil we have come across. So, or otherwise, a very heavy loads are coming into from the lower superstructure to the that particular column. So, in both the cases, we cannot spread the foundation to a greater extent area. There is a restriction. So, sometimes boundary restrictions will be there. Sometimes even economical restrictions also come into the picture. So, that type of situation, so these loads will be transmitted to the wider area by providing the grillages. So grillages of two types of beams will be used, right angle directions, and these beams will take care of it, the transmitting to a larger area of the contact area of the soil. So what is that? In such situations, the gradual expansion from the small column base plate to the larger foundation base is done by means of the grillage foundations. So as I said to you, so all of a sudden we cannot increase the foundation area. So by means of these grillage foundations, we will spread very safely the total transmitted area load to the soil, to the subsoil by means of this. So grillage foundations will be useful at that type of situations. So now this is the four types of column bases. One is slab base, another one is gusset base, third one is pocket base, and fourth one is the grillage foundation. This is the one, and how we will design it, these foundations, we will see. So designing is the most important element in any structural design part. The safety of the structure is depending upon the design only. So each and every component has to be designed in a proper way, and then it should be checked thoroughly by all the considerations of design considerations, and even characteristics, strengths of that particular elements and all. So let us see what is the design of slab base. The following are the major design considerations. One is the size of the base plate. As I said to you, size is the most important one. So how the size is comes according to the safety of that bearing capacity, safety of that structure, and how much area is needed to transmit that particular load to a subsoil condition. So depending upon the various characteristics, so this size of the base plate can be determined. And second one is thickness of the base. So again, after determining the size of the base plate, we have to come across how much thickness we have to use it, and the thickness should be economical and it should be safety also for the design point of view. So both the conditions have to be fulfilled by way of designing this thickness of the base. So let us see the size of the base plate. So size of the base plate is depending upon the, as I said to you, that by the formula we can use it to determine the bearing pressure. This is W is the bearing pressure coming onto the foundation level. So how this bearing pressure is will be governed? It should be governed by the axial load of that column and moment of the column. So there will be in each structure, there will be a direct axial load also, which will be coming directly from the top, and another one is the moment. So there will be an eccentricity of such a certain forces which can create a moment into the in that column. So both the things have to be considered. So according to that axial load, that area of the base plate is coming to the contact. So another one is this one, because moment has taken care by total thickness and other factors also, that is the section modulus of this plate, whereas P is the axial load on the column, M is the bending moment of the transmitted, AB is the area of the base, that is B into D, that width into breadth of the rectangular base, and Z is the sectional modulus of BD square by 6 is the for rectangular base, and other bases also it is similar one. So this is the once you know it, that pressure of coming onto the base plate, you can easily decide the how much area it is needed to the base plate. So this way we can design the base plate size. And second one is the thickness of the base plate. So as I said to you, thickness also a very important role which provides the safety as well as other considerations also. So those T will be calculated by the square root of 3W and sigma. This is the characteristics of that material, which that mild steel, if you use it, this is the one thing. If it is other type of material, and this sigma BS will change, and A square minus B square by 4. These A square is B square is the two projections. Normally each base plate is a bigger base plate than the column size. So certainly sometimes this is a one projection to the one direction, length direction, and this projection may be beyond the column to the widthwise direction. So A is the, as I said to you here, the greater projection of the plate beyond the column. So this is the bigger projection I am calling as A, and B is the smaller projection, which it may be a width direction or it may be a length direction also, depending upon the situation. So A and B are the projections of that plate beyond the columns, where sigma B is the permissible bending stress of that slab, that material, and W is the pressure coming onto the that base plate. So these are the factors which influence the thickness of the base plate. So this is the way we can calculate the base plate thickness. And so now we see the constructional aspects of the slab base. Slab base is a simple base, as I said to you earlier. So it is a rectangular concrete block which is embedded to the soil, which can hold the column. So column lower ends is welded to the steel base plate. So here this welded, sometimes it may be welded or sometimes it may be anchored by a anchoring bolts, which can be tightened by nut and washers to the required tensions, required tensional force. So this is a first step. Another one is grout is done below the base plate for minor adjustments. So there will be a condition always in the site, there may be a minor adjustments are needed when you place the column on the slab base. So to take in care of that minor adjustments, so grouting has to be done in between the minor adjustments. Third one is anchor bolts heads are provided with the proper tightening arrangements, nuts up to the proof stress level in the bolt. As I said to you, there may be a welded connections and there may be a bolted connections also. Either way, it can be anchored the column to the slab base. So these to be taken care by proper arrangements of nut and one bolt, and then and tolerance also should be within the limits. These bolt shafts are encased in furrows or pipe which are embedded in the concrete and is subsequently grouted. And these, as I said to you, these are also important ones in a SAB base. Suppose in a design, if we this anchoring of the bolts are weakly designed, then the structure will be failed in the connections. That means either it may be welded connection or bolted connection. It has to be taken care properly in both the cases. Or otherwise, if everything is properly designed, if you have not properly designed for this connection, and the safety of the structure will be in a question mark. So please take care of that one while designing this one also. So fourth one is the minor alignment of column. A tolerance of about 2 mm is provided in the bolt holes. So there will be a minor adjustment is needed according to the requirement of the placement of that particular column. So there should be a tolerance will be available for each and every column base fasteners of 2 mm is to be provided. So then accordingly it should be adjusted, and then it should be tightened and it can be placed in the proper way. So for sixth one is the alignment of column and the level of foundation base must be properly checked before placing the grouting. So as I said to you, there will be a grouting procedure. So this grouting procedure will help us in adjusting the proper alignment. Either it should be vertical or horizontal also. So that grouting must be properly checked before doing the grouting. Everything is in proper and then grouting will be done. So this will be placed very correctly. So this is the situation for. So now let us see how this designing of slab base has been done. So let us consider some examples. We will discuss, and then we will understand completely well about all the design aspects. So let us see the first one example. Column of ISMB 400 is subjected to axial force of 750 kilonewtons. The design the base plate assuming M15 pedestal concrete mix. So now this solution is axial force is P, that is 750 kilonewtons, which is coming onto the column directly from the superstructure. So flange size is of MSME 400 is 140. This we will take it from the steel tables. So this is assuming a 24 mm bolts used as an anchor bolts. So that bolt hole should be, there should be a tolerance of 1.5 mm. These are all thumb rules. So one can you might have been come across while designing the fasteners of these elements. Minimum tolerance is 1.5 mm should be added, and this will be 25.5 mm. So the bolt is hole is 25 mm. So distance of the center of the hole from the outer edge is equal to 44 mm. So one side is 44 mm. Distance of center of hold from the rolled section is 35 mm. Another one A and B, as I said to you. So these are the distances from the steel structure. Hence minimum width of the plate is 140 plus, this is the dimension coming from the ISMB 400, and another one is, so we have to add in the two sides, that means 44 plus 38, that is 2 into thus minimum width is coming to 204 mm. So minimum length of plate is D, is again, as I said to you, in one direction this is 1.40 and another direction ISMB 400, that means 400 is the length of the column. So this is the breadth and this is the length. So 400 plus 2 into 44 plus 35 equal to 564 mm. So assuming that 320 by 580 mm size plate for a slab base. So this is the round off figure, so we can do it in higher side because stability will be there for if you choose the higher dimensions. We go and calculate the thickness now. So here both the projections A and B has taken are 90 mm, and this is the base plate projections as I am talking about it beyond the column. So both the projections I have taken are assuming a 90 mm projection, uniform pressure below the plate because there is no movement. So that's why I have taken a uniform projections of 90 mm from each side of the plate. So So now W is calculated by P by B and D. So this here is total load is in newtons I have converted. So 750 newtons by divided by 320 into 580. This is the base plate I have chosen. So now the pressure is coming 4.04 megapascals. Hence the thickness of the plate is given by the formula that 3 by into this much under root, that is here. So 90 minus 90 square by 4, which is coming 19.9 mm, which is equivalent to 20 mm thickness. So here the base plate has been as the size of this much, and the thickness of 20 mm plate has been used, which is can be taking care of 750 axial load of that column. So this is the first step of that design. Now how you will come across to the thickness and size by seeing this example. Now second, hence these 320 and 580 into 20, as I said to you, thickness of the plate is provided. Next, we calculate the size of the concrete pedestal. So that this is the base plate, which is as I said to you, this is the column base in between the pedestal and this one. So element, base plate element, and now this concrete pedestal, which is a column, both together will be called as a column base. So assuming 40 mm as a cover of reinforcement, and diameter of the bar is 20 mm in that slab base, and furrow diameter, as I said to you, anchor bolts which needs a furrows and other things, accessories, there are 75 mm. Then width of the pedestal is come into the picture is 320 is the base plate, which has to be placed on the concrete block, plus 2 into 40 and 20, this is the cover and this is the diameter, 75 by 2, which is a central, from central place we will consider it, and this is the adding total, which will come across 525 mm is the width of the pedestal. So length of the pedestal, similar way, that 580 is the length, plus same thing, 2 into 40 plus 20 plus 75 mm, that 750 mm is coming. So sigma BC here, that M15 concrete has been used, so which is having a characteristic strength of 4 megapascals is the characteristics for M15 concrete. So steel plate area is coming B into D, that as I said to you, the base plate 320 into 580, which is an area of 1,85,600 mm square. This is in mm actually. Concrete area is again coming, so 435 into 70, that is 3,04,500 mm square. So by allowing allowable bearing pressure will be calculated by sigma CC is equal to AC by AP, that is area of concrete by, that ratio is area of concrete by area of plate. So 4 into that both the areas ratio under root, which comes to 4 into 1.25, that is 5.13 megapascals, will take care by this complete column base. So this much of load, whereas it is coming from, because of the load, 4.13. So hence the pedestal is the safe. It should be always greater than this required one. If it is less than this, then the whole problem is again redo by increasing the size of the base plate or increasing the size of the base plate. So now it is safe. So that's why by this way we can able to design the column base. So let us see the second example of which is a gusset base. So design a gusset base for the column consisting of ISHB 250 section with two cover plate 300 by 25 mm. It carries an axial load of 2500 kN. So, and is supported on a concrete pedestal. Permissible bearing pressure of the concrete is 4 megapascals. So first let us consider, though without gusset. Without gusset, how this dimensions are coming? Let us check it. Required area of the slab base is equal to that total load, which is 250 kilonewtons, 2500 kilonewtons by 4, which is the permissible bearing pressure of that concrete. So I wanted to take out the how much area is required. So by dividing the characteristic strength of that permissible pressure, so I got an area of 625,000 mm square. So this is assuming a square base. I can assume a square base as well as rectangle base also. So because here dimensions of ISMA 250 is the section, so cover plate are 300, it is nearby, so I have assumed a square base. So 800 by 800 mm, that actual base area, which is higher than 6 lakhs as a requirement, 625,000, it is more than that. So 800 by 800 I have assumed it. Bearing pressure, actual bearing pressure coming on the site because of the load is, again, I will be calculating depending upon the size. So which comes to 3.9 mm square, this one, bearing pressure. So now projection of the base plate from column in either, this is the megapascal, sorry, I am here, mm square, either direction of A is will be is equal to 250 mm. So here projections I have taken 250 mm because of more area is coming on the base at the pedestal point of view. So 250 mm is taken by both the directions. Thickness of the base plate T is calculated by this formula, 3W by sigma BC A square minus B square by 4, which is coming, that 3 into 3.9 is the actual pressure is coming, and this is the permissible strength, and these are the projections, maximum, minimum, both are the same. So now the thickness is coming 54.4 mm. That we can consider a round off of 56 mm. So base plate of 56 mm, and this square base of 800 by 800 is the one which is sufficient for the this to 2500 kilonewtons. So with gusset plate, so using 600 mm gusset plates and ISA 200 by 150 by 12 mm gusset angles. So as I said to you, in gusset base, always we can use other combination of angles, which will provide an opportunity to us to reduce the thickness of the gusset base plate. So here these angles will be used, make it the gusset base. So width of the base plate is equal to 250 plus 2 into 25 plus 2 into 150 is the this angle also I have to consider. So which comes to 635, say 650 mm. So whereas that in the first one 800 mm is coming, here see this is coming 650 mm. So length of the base plate is, so by dividing the area 650, that 962 mm says 1000 mm. So lengthwise here is the rectangular base plate has come, adopt a 650 into 1000 mm base plate. So column paste for the complete bearing. So in this condition, there are two conditions we can assume it. So first condition is column paste complete bearing. So so load taken by the fasteners on both the faces of column equal to, that is half of the load we can consider it in this case. So now it can be multiplied by 0.5, which the load is 1250 kilonewtons has been taken because of this condition of complete bearing. So if it is not complete, it is not a complete bearing, then it will be taken at total load. So using 22 mm diameter power driven shaft rivets, strength of rivet, each rivet in single shear. So this is the area of the rivet. These are the characteristics of that material. So now 43.37 kilonewtons is the strength in single shear of that rivet. So similarly, the strength of bearing also on 16 mm plate, how much bearing strength will be there for each rivet also, we have to calculate that this is the 16 mm is the thickness, this is the diameter of the hole, and this is the permeable stresses. Now this is coming 112 is the strength which is in bearing of that particular rivet. So out of these two, which one is the smaller one we have to consider while designing a smaller load, taking care of this one is the smaller one. So this should be divided by the total load. So now the number of rivets will be given. So if it is higher one, if you taken, those number of rivets are less, and then in the that joint will be failed in single shear. So that's why we have to take the either of the minimum one. So this is the 43.37 kilonewtons has been taken as a rivet value, and it has been divided by that value. We will get the number, how many number of rivets we have to provide for the connection. So here 28.8, so it is nearly 29 rivets is coming. So it should be, either I have to divide into two rows, so 30 rivets have been round off, I did it, and so now provide 30 rivets, 15 on each face. So both the faces 15 I have to use it. Using three rows means five each can be accommodated within the 250 mm wide flange for connecting the base plate with the gusset angle. Minimum of 15 rivets must be used. So this is the requirement because of the design. So thickness of the plate is checked at a critical section X and Y cantilever projections at X is equal to, that is 650 is the width of the plate by divided by 2, minus 250 is the that rolled, so that column 1 divided by 2, plus 25 plus 16 plus 12, which comes to 147 mm. This is the critical section will be coming at this, so bending moment I have to calculate the remaining projections area that at that point. So maximum bending moment at this section is equal to, that is the, this is the pressure is coming, that 4 kilonewtons. So into 147, this is L square by 2, WL square by 2. So which is bending moment at X is equal to 43,200 Newton meter per mm. So for mm length of the base plate. So column base. Hence the thickness of the plate is, so this is 6 mm. Divided by this sigma BC, which is the 185 for that particular metal. So T1 is equal to, which is coming at 37.4 mm. This thickness is coming here in this case. So similarly, we have to see the all the characteristics, strengths of the thing, and the various moments at that. These are the resistance moments of different places have to be considered while designing the any base plate. So similarly, bending moment at the section y is equal to, in a, that is a widthwise direction, this is a particular direction, 4 into 333 divided by 8, WL by 8, this is a simple one, minus 4 into WL square by 4, this is coming 29,831 Nm. Hence the thickness of the plate T2 is here 31.7. So here adopt the 33 thickness of the plate, and the thickness of the available at X is equal to 32 plus 12, that is 44, which is greater than 37 mm. So earlier case is 37 mm, so here I have to provide this 12 mm tolerance also, because of thickness of other things, that 44 is coming, so 30, it is requirement is 37 only for this T1 side, so it is safe design. So like this, actually we have to design the columns for each and everything. As I said to you earlier, column has not faced the complete bearing. In that situation, what will be happening, let us see. In this case, fastening taken place full column load. So column fastening on fastening is equal to 2500 kilonewtons. Number of rivets required is equal to same that load by that same rivets I am using. So value is 43.37. So which is coming 57 is coming. See here, the double the rivets because of complete bearing. Here complete bearing is taking place. So that's why number of rivets are more. Power driven 58 rivets, 25 in each flange, and 8 in the web. So here arrangement of the rivets also we have to consider, because of it needs some place of that fastening. So we have to consider, we have to plan it. So 25 in the flange and 8 in the web also. So total it is coming 32, and the rivets of the web and the double shear. So because of this here, the arrangements of, depending upon the arrangement of the rivet, it will be, sometimes it will be a single shear, sometimes it will be a double shear. So double shear means if two plates in come into contact, so on top and bottom, so each rivet will be sheared at two places of its strength. So that's why two places it will cut, so double shear strength will be considered. So here the similar way we have to double shear. So strength of the rivet in double shear we have to calculate, the 2 into 43.37 equal to that 86.74 kilonewton. Strength of the rivet in the bearing on 6.9 mm web. So web thickness is 6.9 mm. So that's why, so web thickness here I will be considered in bearing strength of the rivet. So this is the diameter of the rivet into the thickness of that web by permissible stresses, which is coming 48.68 kilonewtons. So out of these two, least I have to consider. So rivet value is 48.65 kilonewtons, smaller one of the two has been taken. So hence the load on all rivets 50 into 43.37 plus 8 into 48.68, which is coming 2557 kilonewtons. It is higher than our requirement load requirement. So the design of base plate will remain the same in the case 1. So similar either case 1 or case 2, which we will see, we have seen the load is taken care in the case 2 also in the with the similar fasteners. So like this we have to design the either it is a gusset base or it is a column base. So the main point is size of the base plate, thickness and the connections. So most these three are important ones. How you have been seen the how these three have been designed and arrived a safe design of base plate and gusset base. So now let us see the other example, other one. So one thing here, second base is another example of design a column base of column ISMB 300 section. It carries an axial load of bending moment of 50 kilonewtons in the plane of the web. The bolts are having the pre-tensioned of 150 megapascals. Allowing bearing pressure here also will be taken as 4 megapascals. So in this design, how we will design it, let us see. Bearing pressure is 4 megapascals and moment is 50 kilonewton meter. That is, if I convert into newton centimeters, you can see that which is coming 50,000 lakhs is coming. We have BD square is equal to 12 M by W is the formula. So here from this formula I will consider the breadth. I assumed this much of area is coming. So B is, I assumed it 500 is the breadth. We have arrived at D of 550. So here the concrete base may be 5 into 550 square, almost square, so in plane. So the T is tension, how much is coming is to be determined. So T is equal to half of BD minus P, that is equal to 1 by 2 into 4 into 500 into 550 minus, this is the P, which total load is coming onto the structure. So that comes to be 250,000 newtons, which is coming 250 kilonewtons. So area of the bolt is again load by permissible load of that bolt. So 142 here, this metal is considered as much as the load can taken care, permissible load can be taken. So this was 1760 mm square area is needed to carry. So use 4 bolts of 25 mm dia bolts. So 25 mm diameter of the bolt has been considered. So 4 numbers, if it is taken care, so greater than this, more than this area is thumb, so which can be taken care of. The critical section of the base plate will be at 0.95 of base. So half of the base is coming, so 142.5 mm at 1.2 mm critical section is coming. So how much is the projection beyond the column is coming? So this has to be 250 has to be taken out this 142 critical section. So 107.5 mm from the edge is coming. So calculate the actual pressure distribution below the plate. So because this moment is there, so the pressure distribution may not be a uniform one. So let us see how much pressure is coming. Omega is equal to T plus T divided by A plus or minus M by Z. So by this formula, so either it should be a compression and tension depending upon the moment. So there are one is if I consider plus, that is 4 approximately is coming. If I consider negative, it is very less, so which can be negligible. So bending moment per mm width is this much because of this projection, it is a critical section. So thickness I have calculated, the 26.5 mm using the 500 by 550 into 30 mm base plate. Here requirement is 26.5, higher side I have taken, so 30 mm base plate has been used as a column base. So this is the way, so we have to design and check the column basis, either it's gusset basis. So column base and gusset basis have been designed by this way. So while designing the whole section, one should consider the each and every parts, all critical components, so in any design process.